Ah. Σταυρωθείς σε Χριστέ ο Θεός, παράδοτα τα κόμματα. Thank you. Μόνο εγώ έβαλα glory and show of the world, whom you gave your only begotten Son, so that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. He came and fulfilled his divine plan for us on the night when he built it up. Arriving when he gave himself up the life of the world, he took bread that was holy, pure, and laid his hands, gave thanks, blessed, sanctified, broke, and gave it to his holy disciples and apostles. Father, with the voices of Sona, joy that we're born and known, in salvation of the own. Take heed, this my body, which is broken for you, for forgiveness of sins.
Remember also, Lord, that to reach my soul to mind, and all your people, you want to make us a God. Before she ascended into heaven, she had two other ladies that were
they cared for her, and before she died, she gave the robe that she wears, the veil that goes over the head, and sort of like something like this, but over the head, and that was given to one of the ladies that was with her, and that robe survived for up to the 5th century, because there were two visitors that went to Jerusalem, and they visited this lady. I don't know how they knew her, but she was a lady in Jerusalem, and those would have ailments. They would come to her house, and she would, and they would be healed. And they wanted to know how she was being healed. And she would actually didn't want to give the information because of the value of this veil that she had. But she told the story eventually, and it kept pressing and pressing. And they finally told her that the veil was a theotokos. It was given to her, who knows, great great grandma, from generation to generation, to her who had it at her home. And miracles were being were happening because of the veil. Then this veil was transferred to Constantinople. These two emissaries of Constantinople took it to the, and they built the church in the Constantinople. And there, still, there were miracles performed before, and I'm not exactly sure where it is today. The church that they built was outside of the suburb of Constantinople. It's not existing anymore, and I'm not sure where it is today. But anyway, wherever it is, miracles are performed because of the Theotokos. The temple of God. Who is the temple of God? God says, you are the temple of God. He says that to us. And what is the temple? Here we have the temple over here, the physical temple. We have the altar. But if you read the epistle, it tells us, again, the physical temple of God. And let me just read it because it's so profound in its way. It says, the first covenant had regulations for worship, and an earthly sanctuary for a tent was prepared. In other words, the Jewish people were given the Ten Commandments. They had a covenant. It was a regulation and to live by, in which was the lampstand and the table and the bread of presence. It is called the holy place, the tabernacle. Behind the second curtain stood a tent called the Holy of Holies, having the golden altar of incense and the Ark of the Covenant. The Ark of the Covenant. What did the Ark of the Covenant contain? It contained the rod of Aaron, which Aaron was the priest, the first priest of the Levites. And he had a rod, a cane, when they were walking in the desert. And so he put it in the sand, and the next day it blossomed, it bloomed. And that is in the covenant, that was in the Ark of the Covenant, which is still there today. We don't know where the Ark is. And the other thing that they did, they gathered the manna when they were in the desert, and when they were hungry, they had no food. The manna, the miracle of God, came down every day, and they would eat the manna. You couldn't save it or anything like that. So what is manna? We don't really know. But it was a sustenance for the people that were wandering in the desert, another miracle, and that was put into the Ark of the Covenant. And the other thing in the Ark of the Covenant, of course, is the Ten Commandments. So you have those three items in the Ark of the Covenant. And it says here, of which contained the golden urn called holding the manna and Aaron's rod that budded. And the king, and these things were cannot. And the tables in the covenant above were the cherubim of glory overshadowed the mercy seat. In other words, the Ark of the Covenant had the two angels above it, covered in gold. And these are the things that we cannot speak in detail. These preparations, having thus been made, the priests go continually into the outer tent, performing their ritual duties. But in the second only, in other words, the temple was built. The temple outside, the people were there every single day. But in the Holy of Holies, the high priest would go into the Holy of Holies once a year, and not without taking blood, which it was a sacrifice to have the lamb, and they would sacrifice the blood of the lamb on the altar, which he offered for himself and for the errors of the people. So the temple was and still is, because we are a continuation of the temple. It is a bloodless sacrifice, not a blood sacrifice, but who was the blood sacrifice? Jesus was the last blood sacrifice. And therefore, when we have this commemoration of the bread and the wine being brought and being actually the body and blood of Jesus in the temple, and I will receive that, we receive that God Himself. So we have here, what is the temple? Who is the temple? I'll tell you who the temple is. Here we have a temple here. The Virgin Mary. What did she contain? She contained the Holy of Holies, the All Holy, Jesus Himself. She received Jesus by the exception, because Jesus was coming into the world, and she was asked, would you bear the Christ, but you will suffer, because there will be many things that you will experience that will bring suffering to you. And she received Jesus in her womb. So she is the temple. She carried the Christ Himself. Just as the altar is the Holy of Holies, and we receive the body and blood of Christ. The temple. She's the temple. Who else is the temple? We are. God says it. I created you. You are the temple of God. You yourselves are the temple of God. Imagine that. We accept and believe in Christ and who He is, and we become the temple of God. And when we receive Holy Communion, we receive God Himself in ourselves. And we also carry God in ourselves by Holy Communion. You realize that you have received communion, as I have almost all my life, and you, many of you have. You actually walk in this world carrying the Lord Himself, physically, the temple of God. That's who you are. And God has given us that gift. And what a gift it is. You know, some people come up casually. Oh, I think it's a nice ritual. It's a very nice thing to do. No. We are receiving Christ Himself, as Mary received Christ Himself in her womb. For he offers Himself, He offered Himself to the human race through Mary, and He offered Himself to the human race through the holy altars of Christ. And who does He who receives it? We, who are the temple, who are created in His image, are the temple of God. Many people, again, casually, and I think it's a big mistake, I've said it many times, especially in Greece and other countries, they receive the communion once a year. Once a year? What does that mean? Oh, because I'm not worthy. That's what they say. And I believe some of the priests, too, they say, oh, no, you've got to fast. No, before you receive Holy Communion, you have to fast at least 7 days. So that was meant, I think, by many, well, if I receive a Holy Communion, I'll never be able to eat. Because I can't, because I'll be fasting forever all my life. And that doesn't seem right, and it's not right. We have a fasting period, we have a fasting time, a discipline, that we have on Wednesdays and Fridays to fast. The rest of the week we eat. And then there are four fast periods throughout the year. And if you fulfill that, you've completed your fasting period. And they used to say, and I would say it from people from other countries, and they would say, oh no, I saw somebody eating meat on Saturday. And then the next day they would receive communion. perfectly allowed if you fast in the fullness of the fast. And so they were received once a year. I said, well, once a year, maybe on Christmas, maybe. Maybe. That's wrong. Why is the priest up there every week? The priest is up there every day, and some monastery they do a liturgy every day. Why do they do it? So the body and the bread and blood may be consecrated to the body and blood of Christ. And somebody has to take that. The priest can't go up there. That's why you need two people. Where two or three are in my name, I am there also. And Christ is there also. But if he doesn't do the liturgy by himself. There has to be another person in there. Why? To receive the body and blood of Christ. Otherwise he would do it and then it would just, what does he do with it? It is for the people. So yes, receive communion as often as you can. When we have done things that we should not be doing, then maybe abstain from it here and there. But there are ways of remedying that. Confession, of course, or whatever it might be to say, able to come up and receive Holy Communion. And we never come up worthily. Oh, look at me, God, I'm coming up and I'm doing you a favor and I'm going to receive your body and your blood. No, I'm coming up unworthily. I don't even deserve it. But God says, come anyway. Because I am your Lord, you are my people, and you are part of me. That's the whole idea of liturgy. That's the whole idea of why we're here. So that we could be part of God. What other reason would there be? So we are, again, the temples of God. We are the temple of God. As Mary, again, whom we celebrate today. We celebrate the robe of Mary that performed miracles throughout the world. And we are, again, glad for our Lord being so gracious. And sometimes I think maybe we overdo it. We make God as a very harsh person. A person that if you did that, boy, you're going to get it good. No, that's false. God is always compassionate, always understanding, always ready to forgive, always. Why are there icons that cry? Mary cries, there are icons with tears. Why? Because of the sins of the people. And then and the whole idea is to cleanse ourselves, to be back to our Lord, that we can be part of him and the temples of whom he created. He gives himself to us, his people. And may he bless you all.
Thank you. Good morning.
How are you?
Can you find the name of it?